home number 78. With every moment, it breaks and crumbles on demand, shattering the earth in a forceful impact. It raises heartbeats, widens eyes, and steals precious breath as it grasps ambition and takes it by the hand. A racehorse! We need to find a racehorse!
There was this guy named Thunderdays. He was really great in the 80s. He's the closest horse to Secretary's record.
Wow, he sounds like our guy. Where is he?
Last I heard, he was in jail. So I don't know how I feel about going there.
Oh no, mister. We're going to find that treasure. I know you want it, right?
I need it.
Everything's fine. A little treasure isn't going to hurt us. All this stress will be over once we find it. Don't worry.
But isn't true treasure memories? Moments?
I want something that will make me happy forever. What do memories and moments come from? People. And what do? People lie, make fun, and disappoint. That's exactly why I had to send Ruth home. She calls Cash a traitor when all he's ever tried to do is help us. Piper, are you okay? You sure do look a little scared.
I'm not scared. I'm terrified.
Right this way. I gotta say, I'm surprised you guys are related to him. Whatever runs in his blood is nothing good. And you seem like some nice folks.
I'm sure he just made a few mistakes, that's all.
Ha! A few? Clearly you haven't been doing much catching up with old Thunder. Here he is. Be careful now. He sounds like a drunkard even though he's sane, I assure you.
Thanks. We can handle it. Thunder?
Well, well, well. Someone finally shows up to see old Thunder. Seems as though once the glory days are over, no one gives a donkey's tail about you. Oh, how you doing, Thunder? Been a long time, Thunder. Oh, I'm so sorry, Thunder, that you ended up this way rotten in jail. Is there anything I can do to help? Make you some muffins, bring you some bread.
Do I get any of that?
No, because only people I get to have a day-to-day conversation with are these four walls.
That reaction literally sums up my life.
You all came here for a reason. Then hurry up and get the talking over with.
It seems to me, mister, like you were dying for some attention. So if you really want to talk to another living soul for once, you'd quit being so rude. We don't have muffins or bread, but we do have questions that you're going to answer. Otherwise, you can go back to your four walls. I'm sure they have plenty to say.
How dare you make fun of my only friends?
I don't want to talk to you. Unless you're going to bail me out of here.
What do you know about the Floral Maiden's husband, Bartholomew, and his long-lost treasure?
Hey, that rings a bell. What do you know about him?
You're not asking the questions, I am.
Is this an interrogation?
I guess it is, since you'd rather not chit-chat.
Touché.
Piper, come on, you're wasting time. Let me handle this.
No, let the filly talk. If I'm going to be interrogated, it might as well be by someone who's got some spunk. You seem cranky. And you? You're just quiet.
All right, Thunder. You see, we've been looking for the treasure for a while now, and we've come to this page, an excerpt from one of Bartholomew's collections of poetry. This poem leads directly to you. So we're hoping you've got some answers as to what clue to look for next.
I do know the location of treasure. You wouldn't believe this location's convenience. But if I'm gonna tell you where it is, it better not lead to any consequences for me. I'm already locked up for crying out loud. I know how risky this treasure business is. And you guys better not be criminals yourselves.
We're not criminals. You're the one that's behind the bars, buddy.
Alright, gee. Thought I at least deserved a background check on you guys since you had the nerve to come in and interrogate me.
Trust us, we know what we're doing, and we're doing it for a good cause. Please help us.
Okay, quit whining like I accidentally dropped your favorite doll in the mud and smiled about it with great pleasure. Because the thing cost me a fortune, and you wouldn't stop talking about how obsessed you were with it.
That's quite a specific analogy.
Whatever. You get the point. Anyway, back to the treasure. Alright, so this Bartholomew dude was real smart, right? He knew that, unfortunately, most of the people seeking his treasure are a bunch of criminals, you know, the best of the best. Those who steal priceless jewels, rob banks, oh, and not to mention the rare few who would steal that sweet, fluffy, purebred puppy because it was just so darn cute. So what would be the last place any old criminal would want to show his face? This place right here. Jail. And if he gets caught, he'll never find the treasure because he'll be behind bars for who knows how long. Okay, you caught me. One of the reasons I'm stuck in this place is to guard the treasure. Because it's hidden in these very walls. Not my walls, of course. No. They wouldn't take such a risk.
I can't believe it. Are we really that close to the treasure?
Keep it down! Yes, go to the second level of the basement. Once on the floor, take two rights, go straight past three rooms, then turn left past the third room, and then another right. There, you'll come upon a dead end. You'll come to a door that says, "Do not enter, staff personnel only." Obviously, ignore the sign and enter. Upon entering, you'll see a large cabinet. Open it, step inside, and close the doors. Once closed, a blue button will glow on the top of the interior of the cabinet. Press it. The cabinet will then carry you down like an elevator. Once it meets its destination and the doors open, you'll find your treasure. Here. Take this. The only key in my possession. Too bad it's not the one to set me free. But hey, maybe it'll set you free.
Cash. Do you really think this could be it?
Only one way to find out.
Wait, Ruth isn't here. We can't do it without her.
Of everything we've been through to finally get to this treasure, do you really think the first thing on my mind is whether or not Ruth gets to witness it? It's not like we're gonna give her any.
Our problem isn't Ruth right now. Our problem is the treasure. That's what we care about.
Well, this is it. Little jerk.
I don't understand. I thought we had found it. Is it all a joke? Is the treasure even real?
Of course it's real. It has to be. Maybe someone found it before us and they're just messing around.
But who? Who would do this?
I think we all know exactly who we need to have a little chit-chat with. You think you're real funny, don't you?
What are you talking about?
Seriously? What kind of game are you playing here? Quit lying and tell us where the treasure is.
I did! Tough luck, buddy. Guess treasure isn't always what it's made out to be.
I thought we could trust you. I was so sure you were the answer.
Here's a lesson, sweetheart. Don't trust the guy who's been behind bars and has four walls as his best friends. The truth is, I have no idea what you guys are talking about. Treasure? I could only dream. Some guy came by here earlier telling me you guys were headed this way. He is the one who set this all up. Didn't give me much details, but I thought, hey, why not have a little fun? The only fun I've gotten while being here.
What was this guy's name? Can you tell us that?
Something like Clock? Jock?
Locke? Where is he?
Huh? You know him?
Well, he... I know you're very cautious about the treasure, but I didn't think you'd go this far.
You don't get it, do you?
I don't think I get you. I barely know you, but I can see that you care. It's just, why do you care so much?
I wanted you to give up. I thought that if you saw there was no treasure, you'd be disappointed and you'd forget about it.
Well, if you really knew me, you'd know that I never give up. Well, for a second there, I did feel defeat. It wasn't a very good feeling, and I never want to feel that again. So I guess that makes me stronger. If your goal was for me to lose confidence, then you're fooling yourself.
The truth is, I saw you that night. I saw you sneak into the party like a real pro. You reminded me of my son. He was all for that treasure hunting. I taught him stories of the Floral Maiden, and pretty soon he became a little detective, just like my father and I. He suffered the same fate as my father. That's why I care so much. No one should ever have to die for something so meaningless. I don't want revenge, and I don't wish that it was any other way, because I know it was their time. But what I do want is for you to be safe. And if you're not going to give up, then I'm going to have to stick by you to assure that you make it through.
Story, something to get off my chest. My life gets kind of boring. Need something that I can confess. Till on my sleeves I stained red from all the truth that I've said.
Come by it honestly, I swear. Thought you saw me wink, no, I've been on the brink. So tell me what you want to hear. Something that'll